Peter, we had some rain at the weekend. How welcome was that?
Very, very. Whilst it may have ruined a few people's weekends, it was very, very welcome for us. First rain we've really had here for 10 weeks, and the ground was exceptionally hard. And having the sort of the rain over the weekend has just given it enough give. And you know, we're still working on the ground, so we provide the best possible conditions for the horses. But certainly all that rain has definitely helped us.
Was it enough, though? Well, presumably you don't want too much, because otherwise getting things on site then becomes difficult.
Yeah, no, it stopped just about the right time. We have a lot of movements in terms of getting all the sort of 120 plus trade stands in, getting all our tents up and getting the fences built and so on and so forth. So we didn't really want a huge amount of rain over the course of this week. So it stopped just about the right time, and you know, as it does here at Gatcombe, it's dried out enough, and everyone's getting on and getting ready and excited for the weekend.
And if you hadn't have had the rain, you had plan B as well, to aerate the ground anyway, to give it a little bit of give, didn't you?
Oh, we had a number of plans, to be honest. But you know, the aerator and aggravator, and we've got a number of bits of kit that are used across different events, shared by a number of different events, to just loosen up the top levels of the soil, just to make it easier on the horses. Because you know, Gatcombe's a tough, it's tough on the horses. The horses need to be physically fit to be here. It is a national championship after all. So anything we can do to help them and make that easier by making the ground better is we will always aim to do that.
And entries, how pleased have you been with those? Obviously it's a non-Olympic year, which is obviously going to help.
Yeah, but we got the World Equestrian Games in September in the US, and you know, we've got a stellar international lineup for the British Open, the Magic Millions British Open on Sunday, and obviously we've got the Smith & Williamson Intermediate Championship and the Dodson Hall Norwich Championship as well. And again, all the top riders have got, you know, their future strings, their future four-star horses here, as well as their current championship horses.
And as well as the Corinthian Cup for the amateurs, there's a new class this year, rehabilitation of racehorses. Former racehorses now competing as eventers. How big is that in terms of actually getting a different string of horses here?
Well, to be honest, if you look back to why my parents started this event 35 years ago, it was all about putting something back into the sport. And when we developed the Corinthian Cup a few years ago, about making it a proper grassroots class, and that was one element of it. The retraining of racehorses that we've got coming this year, the first championship, it's one of those ones that's it's actually giving the horses a second chance and second career, and that is something that we you know, not just for the human side but for the equine side as well, we believe very strongly in.
And I suppose the whole process is important to see them, yes, going back to Cheltenham Race Course, but important to see them elsewhere in Gloucestershire, in the equine world, doing what they're doing now rather than what they used to be doing.
Well, I mean, these animals are so multi-talented that it is a shame once they finish racing just to see them in the field. And if they can be retrained to whether it's be dressage, three-day eventing or show jumping, then absolutely we should embrace the fact that, you know, these very talented and smart animals can do that, and they can be retrained.
New role for you this year. You've replaced Tim Henson as event director. I'm sure you've done your apprenticeship though, haven't you?
Yeah, I certainly have. I mean, I don't remember a summer without the horse trials being here at Gatcombe, and certainly starting at the lower levels of painting white stakes and fences, all the way up to sort of ground crew and then management. So it's a different role this year. It's one that's exciting. It's one that's challenging because it is different, and just making sure that I can remember all those bits and pieces from years gone by and how they all fit together. So it's been challenging, but at the same time, you know, this is about moving the event forward and the evolution process of the event. Tim Henson did an amazing job setting a fantastic putting fantastic groundworks in place and putting a great festival on. It's now up to me and my new team to be able to take that on to the next level.
And event organizing, that's what you do anyway, that's your job, isn't it?
Yeah, that's certainly part of my job, you know, the fact that you can do something that is your job and also is something that's close to your heart is always a good thing.
Your father's still designing the cross-country course. How happy is he with that?
Yeah, no, I think he's a lot happier today because he had the stewards go around yesterday with him and they did their course inspection, so everyone was happy with that. But again, for me, this is a family event. It was important that he remain part of the team. He's still chairman of the event, and you know he is he's one of the world's greatest course designers. And why do you want to not have him here designing the national championship courses?
Has anything changed this year? Obviously, you got the new lake in a little while ago. I mean, presumably, that's just still bedding down.
I think the without wanting to give too much away, I think there were subtle changes. I think last year he held his hands up and said he got one or two things wrong on the cross country course. This year he's made some changes. So you know, the riders, I think, will they'll still need to walk the cross country course to work out where it's going. But I think they will hopefully see that it's a better flowing course than it was last year. But I mean, off the course, there are a few changes that the public will see, nothing major, but again, this is part of this evolutionary process. So, you know, trying to develop the event side of it as well as the sports side of it.
And how many people are you expecting here? Because it's tens of thousands, isn't it?
No, absolutely. Yeah, we have a fantastic support base locally, and I hope that people will continue to come and support a local event. And you know, we have, as I said, we have over 120 trade stands here, as well as five national championship classes from a sporting perspective. But you know, one thing we're very keen to do is maintain that family friendly atmosphere. It's not as big as badminton, so you don't sort of feel lost. It's got that nice sort of small feel, but at the same time, it's a relatively big event. So for me, it's grown, and from where we started, and we keep trying to make it better for people when they come through the gates.
And the bowl for the cross-country course, that just naturally lends itself that you can see so much of the action at one point in time, doesn't it?
Well, we've got two spots, actually. We've got the park bowl, as you mentioned, right in front of the house, the main house. And then on Evening Banks, we put the two new water complexes in there. And that, again, is that you can sit in two places and see pretty much the whole cross-country course. And that is fairly unique to the sport. And when you're watching these incredible animals and the top-level athletes, you know, it's a joy to behold to be able to sit there and watch them jump, you know, half a dozen fences without having to walk around.